here we go. The play, the play, the play, the PlayStation 1. The play, the play, the PlayStation 1. The play, the play, the PlayStation 1. Dominated the whole market. The play, the play, the play, the PlayStation 1. The play, the play, the PlayStation 1. The play, the play, the PlayStation 1. Dominated the whole market. You got to understand, the PlayStation 1 is far better than the Saturn. It has more games, a decent controller, and a popular reception among critics. Peace out, players.
WCW Mayhem was a game that was released in 1999, both for the PlayStation 1 and the Nintendo 64, and there was even a port on Game Boy Color, which came out a year later. Interestingly enough, both the PlayStation and the N64 versions actually came out on the same day. Another thing you might notice is that it was never released in Europe for the N64 at least, but was for the PlayStation. Enough, I don't want to say enough mumbo jumbo here, but I do want to bring your attention to the actual pay-per-view, Mayhem 99. You might actually notice that the game WCW Mayhem was actually released before the pay-per-view event took place by 3 months, which is insane because why would they do that? I honestly don't know. In the actual pay-per-view, basically what happened was there was like some kind of a tournament thing with the WCW World Heavyweight Championship Tournament. It was semifinals and finals, and Bret Hart actually managed to defeat Chris for the title. It was actually pretty good, but nonetheless, I don't want to do this mumbo-jumbo. Let's dive right into it. So the intro features somewhat of a CG kind of Goldberg being created. And, you know, he just gets too out of control and stuff. He does a Grelopus Slam or something like that. I can't remember what it's called. And then he runs through the ring. And then it finally cuts to real-life footage of WCW. And that's cool. You get to see actual WCW footage. It definitely brings back the old memories, too. I mean, granted, I was born, basically, the year WCW started falling downhill. Even so, WCW was still good. But let's not focus on that. Here's the actual game. So the menu does feature somewhat good options to choose from. It features Quick Start, which you basically pick a superstar and it picks a random arena's opponent for you. Main Event, you can basically specify your settings. Quest for the Best, you can compete for championship titles. Pay-per-view Password, we'll get to that later. Create Wrestler, and Global Options, which is just basically an options menu. Now, apparently, one thing that I do want to mention is that Mayhem was also the first WCW game to actually feature all 12 pay-per-view events, such as Slambori, Starrcade, Halloween Havoc, etc. And also, as well as the three major WCW shows, such as Nitro, Thunder, and Saturday Night. You know, WCW Saturday Night. I'm not sure if you guys are familiar with that, but whatever. But let's not focus on that. Let's just move on. So the game actually does feature a good roster. I mean, it's not the best WCW roster, but it was pretty good though. I mean, the characters, the way they're modeled, they're not perfect though. But I mean, in WCW Nitro and Thunder, I hate to admit this, but they actually looked better than Mayhem, in my opinion. I mean, it was developed by Electronic Arts, so like, you know, everything is completely different. But they don't look god-awful. It could have been better, though. But then again, it's just a minor nitpick about the models, I know. But I'm just trying to put this out of perspective. I hope you guys can understand what I'm trying to say here. You know, you can basically pick the NWO, Wolfpack, Four Horsemen, etc. You know, basically all those other guys. So yeah, this game does have a decent roster. And the arenas do look pretty good on PS1 for at least, you know, back in 1999. Not to mention, the entrances look really good. You know, they do their poses and then they walk to the ring. And the commentating is done by Bobby the Brain Heenan and Tony Schiavone. And they both do a fantabulous job on this one. Wait, did I just say fantabulous? Whatever, it doesn't matter. But yeah, the entrances look good, and not to mention the announcers actually talk about the wrestlers while they're walking to the ring, which is a really good thing. In fact, people compare the commentary in this game to the modern WWE games, which is really good. You know, the commentary in this game is probably the best as far as wrestling games go. I wouldn't even be surprised if WCW Mayhem is often regarded as possibly the best wrestling game with commentary, because the commentary in this game is well done. Now on to the gameplay. The gameplay, the characters do move fluently, even if they do look a little bit weird. But, you know, the gameplay, it's really good, it's playable, but it does have some flaws, though. Like, for one thing, the collision can be way off, even for a PlayStation game, which is crazy. But yeah, and also, when you're sometimes doing an Irish whip, your superstar might pick up a weapon instead, which can be really annoying, though. It can be annoying, but other than that, it's pretty good. Another thing you might notice is that when you run, you have to be pretty much perfect, otherwise you'll trip and fall over and look like an idiot, which is actually pretty funny, by the way. But yeah, even though they do move slow, it's kind of focused on realism here. But yeah, pretty much the gameplay is really good. It's not perfect by any means, but it's pretty good. It's, you know, actually better than WCW Nitro Thunder, I can definitely tell you that. The weapons in the game weren't perfect, but they were good. And going backstage was a good thing that was pretty cool, except that you can't pick any backstage area. The game picks at complete random. That's the only thing, though, and it sucks. Also, you might notice the meters on the bottom. Basically, like the spirit meters. You fill them up and you can pull off your finisher, which, unfortunately, I never got to do in the gameplay, so I really do apologize about that. But I can definitely tell you, it's really good. So, overall, I can definitely say WCW Mayhem is definitely a great game. However, there's one more thing I forgot to mention. The passcodes for the pay-per-view password menu. Basically, what you could do here is that these were a bunch of codes that you could that the players could enter to unlock real-life pay-per-view match lineups. And these codes were given would be given on Monday Nitro broadcast the week before a pay-per-view. And it only lasted for 3 months, ending with, of course, the pay-per-view of the same name. As the game's roster was outdated soon after its release, with several of the featured wrestlers leaving the company, too. And it's funny how they actually encourage you to actually use these passwords. They even give you the site where you can find them. And also, like I just said earlier on in this video, there is a Game Boy Color version of WCW Mayhem. So out of curiosity, I tried it out. And well, you know, it's not bad, actually, once you get to know how to play it. I mean, then again, it's not perfect by any means, but I can definitely tell you one thing. It's better than WrestleMania 2000 on Game Boy. So with the conclusion, WCW Mayhem wasn't perfect by any means, like I just said. Like, many people criticized it for its poor collision detection and also the lack of diverse movesets. However, it was praised for its smooth and detailed-looking graphics, and the sound was praised, too. Even the commentary, too. So, I guess I'll give this game a 7.5 out of 10. I mean, I used to play this game a lot when I was a little kid, so what the heck? It wouldn't hurt. But in any case, I hope you guys did enjoy this review. If there's anything I missed, be sure to let me know. I will be doing more wrestling reviews, of course. So if you guys did enjoy this video, be sure to subscribe for more videos from the Shizzle Network, and leave your comments below if you guys are watching this on the Shizzle Network's website, or YouTube by any means, whatever. And until then, peace out and deuces beyond the infinite.